Humans are really hard to predict and really complicated, and that's just part of human nature. Thankfully, in engineering, we have had a lot of experience studying systems that are complicated and hard to predict, and we've built lots of really good computational tools for understanding those systems. So we're trying to apply these same engineering concepts to human systems. So we're building new computational simulations that allow us to predict human behavior using these core engineering concepts. And these simulations enable us to make really accurate predictions about how people or how teams are going to perform. So it might help support managers in better managing their teams and better supporting their teams to do innovative work and solve the engineering challenges of the world. But it also enables us to study humanity at scale and better understand how things happen at scale. So for instance, one of the things that we're doing with these simulations right now is trying to understand how vulnerable communities, specifically in Alaska, are going to be impacted by climate change. And our objective there is to give these simulations to policymakers and help support them with the right information to make policy to provide protection for these communities. The real power of these models is that they're really fast. So we can run them thousands of times faster than real time, which means that we can create millions of possible futures for engineering design teams or for communities. A recent model that we've been working with focuses specifically on something called cognitive style, which is a measure of more or less how much structure you prefer when you're solving problems. And the cool thing about cognitive style is that there are short surveys that we can give people in order to assess what their style is. So we can specifically model those people in our computational simulations. We can accurately predict, using computational simulations, what the future of design teams or communities is going to look like. And using that knowledge, we can figure out how to better support and better nurture those human systems.